Hi guys, I'm Seema and today we are going to study about number series. I'll be making many more useful videos on topics related to quant, reasoning and English for phase 1 of RBI and SEBI. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and for regular updates, hit the bell icon. Let us move forward to the questions. Question 1. So we have been given a number series and we have to find the next number in the sequence. When we start from the first number, we can see that the second number is 10 into 13 goes for 130. And third number is 130 into 11, which is 1430. I have done nothing but divided 1430 by 130 to find out 11. And now, when we divide by 1430, we see that comes out to be 7. So 1430 into 7 is equals to this, and 10010 multiplied by 5 is 50050. Now we have to find the next number in the series. If we notice these numbers 13, 11, 7 and 5, which are descending numbers, they are prime numbers. So to find the next number in the series, we have to multiply 50050 with the next prime number in a descending order. So the next prime number would be 3. So we will multiply it by 3 and then we get 150150. So the answer is C. Here it is very important to realize that these are prime numbers, or else you could have thought that these are just odd numbers. Then you should notice that 9 is missing because it's not a prime number. Then you'll realize that these are prime numbers, and to get the next number in the series, we have to multiply them by the descending prime number or the prime numbers in a descending order. Question 2. We have been given a series and we have to find the next number. So here, first number is 999. And second is 1000. So we simply see it is nothing but 999 plus 1, which is 1000. And third number is 501. It is roughly half of the 1000. So 1000 divided by 2 plus 1 is 501. And now this 168 is roughly 1/3 of 501. So 501 divided by 3, which is 167, plus 1 equals to 168. And now 168 divided by 4 plus 1, 43, and 43 divided by 5, because now we can see the pattern, plus 1 is equals to 8.6 plus 1, which is 9.6. Here also in the first number you can write it as 991 divided by 1 plus 1, and here in the numerator we are increasing the numerator by 1 every time, and then whatever number comes we are adding 1 to that number. This is the pattern which is followed in this series, and the next number in the series is going to be 9.6. Answer is C. Question 3. So the given series is 19, 2, 38, 3, 114 and 4. So we can simply see that this first number into second number, which is 19 into 2, is 38. Then third number multiplied by fourth number is fifth number. And similarly, 104 multiplied by 4, which is the sixth number, would be the seventh number, 456. This is a very easy question. Here we are also writing the number by which we are multiplying the next number in the series. Don't forget that. If you would have been given the value 456 in the question itself and asked about the value of the eighth number, then it would have been 5. Because we are also writing the number by which we are multiplying the next numbers. Question 4. We have been given 3 fractions and we have to find the third number in the series of these fractions. So firstly, what we should do is we should find the difference. Here you can simply see that to get the second fraction after the first fraction, we add plus 5 and plus 11 in the end. This is the fourth number. So find the difference between the fourth number and first number. So we see fourth number is 39 by 86 and first number is 4 by 9. Do not try and solve fractions mathematically. We're just seeing the denominator and numerator individually. So 39 minus 4 is 35, and this 86 minus 9 is 77. So from first to fifth, these are the differences of denominator and numerator each. So from 35, we know that plus 5 is added in first fraction to get the second fraction. So we could break it up and say plus 5 plus 30, which makes it 35. The sum should be 35. The fourth and first term. And for 77, we could write that plus 11 and plus 66. And we could write that plus 5 and plus 10, then plus 20, which implies that every time is increased by initially by plus 5, then plus 10, then plus 20, and so on. Like the term by which the denominator is increased is multiplied by 2 every time with every increasing number in the series. And similarly, we could write it plus 11, plus 22, and plus 44, which makes it 77 completely. So now we know the second term is plus 5, 9 by 20. And then to get the third term, 9 plus 10, 20 plus 22, which is 19 by 42. This is the third term. And we will also check it further. 19 by 42 plus 20 plus 44 to see if we are getting the correct answer, which is the fourth term, 39 by 86. So 19 by 42 is the correct answer. Option B. Question 5. Find out the missing term. Here, missing term is nothing but the next number in the sequence. So look at these numbers closely. That finding the difference between the two numbers technique doesn't always work in every question. Here you have been given greater numbers. If we observe closely, we realize that from the first term to get the second term, we remove this term, this 4, and we get the second term. From the second term to reach to the third term, we remove the one digit from the right. For the first time, we have removed one digit from the left, then we remove the one digit from right, and this is the third number. We have to alternately remove one digit from left and right each to get the next number in the series. So this is the third number, and we have here to get the third number, we have removed one digit from right. So to get the next digit, we will have to remove this 5, which is one digit from left. So the next digit would be 6, 7, 8, 9, 1. B is the answer. See, this question was having no maths to do, but just a simple observation could help you in the long run to solve such questions in a very little time. Question 6. Find out the wrong term. So here we have been given a series. So let us start by finding the difference between the consecutive two numbers in the series. So 421 minus 300 comes out to be 121. 592 minus 421 is 171. 815 minus 592, 223. 1084 minus 815 is 269. 1405 minus 1084, 321. And 1776 minus 1405 is again 371. So by observing these numbers, we are actually not able to see any connection or link. Let us find out their differences as well. This is 50, the difference between 121 and 171. 171 and this is 52 in the series. 46, these two numbers 52, 321 and 371, which is 50. So here we have realized that either the difference or the number by which this, the difference increases, could be 50 or 52, but not 46. So this makes us realize that there is definitely something wrong with this number, 815, as it is involved in these three numbers, this 46. And if you can see it, this is 50, this is 50. And if we subtract minus 2 from this and 2 from this, which gives us 50, 50. And here also, the difference would become 50 if we subtract 2 from both of these 52s. And to make this 52, 50, if this 223 here, it becomes 221, which means that the difference is, like, number by which the difference is increased is still 50. Like in the case this, then 592 plus 221 becomes 813. And let us see the new series if it satisfy the given condition. 300, 421, 592, 813, 1084, 1405, 1776. Here it is 121, 171, 221, 271, 321, and 371. And after observing, you'll see that difference in these numbers increasing by plus 50. So difference here is plus 50 in all the terms. So we could say that this term, which should be 813, is given as 815 in the question, and it is the wrong term in the question. Hope you found this video beneficial for your preparation, and if you have any queries regarding any of the questions, do let me know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.